When a baby is born, parents and friends gather around the newborn, ooing and awing at the miracle of life. For an instant, they forget the world and its troubles, fascinated by this unique baby, the bearer of hopes and of dreams. But when things go awry, the dream can turn into a nightmare. On this fine Wednesday morning, things are in an uproar at the Barrows home. The family is getting ready to take in another foster child, 14-year-old Jane Jenny Ewing. The Barrows live in a modest two-story home in Welland, Ontario, with their first foster child, little Matthew Reed.
Matthew had been in a foster home and had been with Margaret since he was 10 months old.
2 years earlier, Matthew and his older sister are taken from their own family.
His mom apparently had been suffering from depression and was having some problems, so Children's Aid or FACTS removed him and his sister from the home and put them into foster care. She was dealing with trying to get the kids back at some point and trying to get some help for her mental issues.
On December 14th, 2005, Jenny Ewing arrives at the Barrows home. She is accompanied by a representative of Family and Children's Services Niagara. The foster family knows little about the teenager, aside from the fact that she's had a few problems. The Barrows have only a sketchy idea of the nature of these problems. Something about theft and behavioral problems, nothing more.
First thing Margaret asked them, would Matthew be safe? And because that was a big concern. Matthew was staying, you know, all these other kids came, come and go. And they assured her that Jenny loved children and that there was never any problems, so Matthew would be safe. So under that guise, Jenny needed a foster home, and Margaret is a very experienced foster mom, and she took in a lot of troubled children, so this was one more that needed her, and this is, she opened her home and her arms to her.
It should be mentioned that Family and Children's Services Niagara is usually rather discreet about its charges past. Upon the adolescent's arrival, the Barrows show her around the house and her new room. They also introduce her to little Matthew.
This is
however, Margaret Barrows makes sure not to leave the new boarder alone with the baby.
They were trying to basically kind of keep the kids apart because nobody really knew how Jenny was with little Matthew.
The rest of the day goes by peacefully. Jenny stays in her room, a completely normal reaction for an adolescent who has just been parachuted into unknown terrain.
That evening, Matthew went to bed at 7:30 and Jenny went to bed at 9:30. Margaret checked the kids before she went to bed, and Margaret's daughter, Terry, checked the kids before she went to bed.
The next morning, around 7:30, the household starts its day.
In the morning, Jenny got up. Margaret directed her to the shower, let her know where it was, put the shower on for her. Everything appeared normal.
Margaret makes breakfast for the children and pours herself a cup of coffee. Around 8 a.m., worried about not hearing Matthew, Margaret goes to his room.
Matthew!
She then went up to the child's room and went inside and expected to find him in his bed because he was three and was still in a crib. And instead, she found the child lying on the floor.